Now, the W212 is the version of the E-Class that you will see on the Indian roads this October. But I'm sure a lot of you have already seen those photographs because they've been floating around on the internet even before the car was actually unveiled in Geneva. Its design drew many diverse reactions. Take a look why.
It's different to the stately look one's used to from an E. Its pronounced square jaw and sharper lines have too much of an Americanness to it. It's not round and softly elegant as before, and lots of pointy bits like the V-shaped grille, sharp lights and boot lid with a pronounced crease in the center give it a much more in-your-face attitude. The rear flanks have haunches like the S-Class, and the design is clearly much bolder than the ones we've seen on the previous E's. The daylight running lamps look good, and for me overall it's a bit of a mix and match. Bits I like and bits I don't. So it's not a car I'd go wow over.
On the inside, it feels great. You know, even the doors close with a thunk and everything feels top quality on the inside. But still, there's that feeling of like and dislike because the beige and the chocolate brown on the interior really doesn't cut it with me. It's not something that I like. The switches and sort of buttons on the central console are a little bit small and the console itself is low. But then again, you have things like the stalk, the gear stalk, which has been moved to a lever behind the steering wheel, freeing up a lot of place in the center here, giving you storage and cup holders, which is something the old E-Class never had.
The mixed feeling continues with bits I don't like the side mirrors that are not large enough, and the lack of convex glass in the left mirror limits visibility. But then again, the seats are superb and hugely comfortable. And at last, Mercedes has given a fully power adjustable seat on the E-Class. The earlier cars had sliders for forward and backward adjustments.
I'm starting off in the back seat because this is where most of the owners of the E-Class will be spending their time. The seats are spacious and comfy. But somehow you feel lower in here, and I think that's probably because the window line at the back has gone up by about 18 mm. So for me now, this is eye level and I feel quite low at the back. But otherwise than that, I don't think it really should be called E-Class at the back. It feels more like business class. It really offers you that luxury. You feel cocooned and isolated from the world and really comfortable.
The ride is fantastic. It's much flatter than the earlier E-Class and simply unfazed by the road below. The slight harshness is due to the inordinately high tire pressures that Mercedes recommends. But in the face of competition, the E's ride is truly a class above. That's just for the looks and what's inside this car. For the complete test drive, do watch out for the Autocar Show all of this week.